Good morning, everyone. It's almost time for church. I mean, it is time for church. We're behind the scenes at St. Paul's United Church of Christ, sitting in my office. This is the new stole. I did wear it last week, and it's going to start appearing in the videos all the time. So glad that you're here today. Aspen, good to see you. So this is the time just before the service. It's a quick time to chat, but really a time if you have prayer requests and you'd like me to add them to the prayer request set during the in-person service, or that we pray for them during the week, add them to the prayer list. You can put them down now. Know that they're in a public forum, so other people will see them too. So share as much as you want, share as little as you think is appropriate. Know that when we pray, God hears us, and when we pray, it changes us as well. So welcome to St. Paul's United Church of Christ for Sunday, September 25th, 2022. Hey, edits for your daily. Thanks, no more rooms full of juice. I hope that your prayers come true as well. Edit's doing well. Hello, the Frank Cermak. What's up? Glad that you're here today. It's online church behind the scenes right now, but I'm going to go into the sanctuary in about 3 minutes, and we'll start the service in about 8 minutes. All kinds of stuff today. Regular church, but also, regular church. So glad that you're here. Hey, whoever tried to type something, awful, don't. Hey, Cindy, good morning to you. The topic of the sermon is, it's about peace building, dialogue, and relationships. But it takes a minute to get there, but that's what it's about. Peace building, dialogue, and relationships. Morning, Jenna. Morning, Buff Cat. Anybody have any prayer concerns that you want to have me have in the prayers? Yeah, it is, Frank. This service is going to be online, but we also have a produced online service that you can watch right now. Everything is in my personal profile page, another way for saying my bio. Just go there and click through, and you can find stuff about the church there. Hey, cooking eggs. Great. Scrambled, over easy, omelet. What are you doing? Hello, ex-Mipax. Thanks, Carmel. Daria. Hey, Stan, we're a pro-choice congregation, pro-choice Christians, and God is pro-choice as well. Jenna, college. Scrambled, okay. I make a mean scramble. I'm actually pretty good at making eggs. Don't make them all the time, but when I do. Okay, so it is time for me to go into the sanctuary. What I do when I do that is I go and I have to turn off the comment feed because I can't interact with the comments during the service. So going to turn those off. And are you ready? Because it's time for church. Hey, Ray. Morning, Lucy. Good morning. Morning, Laura.
open up a little thing.
Hello.
Good morning, how you doing?
How are you?
Good to see you.
I'm doing good. Finally got good. A car.
That's awesome. What kind did you get?
Well, it's 2010 Hyundai mm-hmm. Sonata.
The Sonata's last, though.
180,000 miles. My other was a 2008.
Yeah, they'll go. They'll go 180 to 200 without any problem. Yeah.
It's a hard time finding something like.
I know. Well, we Andrew has this old minivan that he drives around. And we thought, let's just sell it and get rid of it and find another one. But we started looking for anything, and they're just the prices on used cars are just outrageous. And nothing's available. So we repaired it.
Well, yeah. What's Andrew doing?
Well, he works mostly over at the church where Deborah's son works. Not Emmanuel. The Lutheran Church in Hinsdale.
Oh, Hinsdale.
Yeah, he is like their Saturday night director kind of thing.
Okay, so
yeah.
He's doing
and music. Assorted things, but music, yeah.
Yeah.
Good. Are we ready?
And how is your wife doing?
She's doing good. It's it is her daughter, Aaliyah's, who is the nursery caregiver. It's her 21st birthday this weekend. So she is down in Kentucky celebrating with her.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
Aaliyah had first glass of wine. She never did before she was 21. And so at 21, she had her first glass of wine with her mama.
And you have grandbabies?
Yes, two and one more on the way.
Yes.
There's
Miller, and what's the other one?
Jameson is the oldest, and then Miller. And then a new baby is coming along in February.
Oh.
I don't know what its name is going to be.
Oh, good. That's a nice surprise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here we go. Is the Prelude the Deborah or? Yeah, yeah.
Number 94, please join us.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. Paul's United Church of Christ for the 25th of September, 2022. Are you ready for our call to worship? We know the presence of God. We encounter the love of Jesus,
who encourages us to remember the good news we have received.
We are inspired by the Spirit,
who reminds us to place our hope and trust in God.
It's time for church. Let us pray. We thank you, O God, for this day, for opportunities to gather however we gather. Help us, O God, to be a people of peace, a caring community of Christ, people of prayer and action. Pray that you would bless us this day and you would join with us in this service. We pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's spend some time passing the peace. Whatever way works best for you, it can be a handshake, it can be a distance air five, it can be high fives in the air, or actually slapping hands, whatever it is. Come up to the camera and say hello to people who are worshiping with us from all over the world as well. Peace be with you. Peace.
Thank you.
announcements today. Who's got announcements to make? Anybody? Gwen, come on up.
Morning. Just a reminder that there is a meeting after church. We'll need a few minutes to get everything in place, but we ask that you all stay if you can and join us for the meeting this afternoon or this morning.
This morning, yeah. Thanks, Ben. Other announcements? Steve?
I just want to say a special thanks to Laura for following through with that awesome thing we had last week. And everybody that was on the committee, Gail, John, everybody. But it was awesome to see people in this church for a change. And it was great looking for a future of everybody being back. Thank you.
Thanks, Steve. It was wonderful. By the way, if you took pictures of that, I haven't seen any yet. I took just a couple of them, but I saw people taking pictures around. Send them to me or send them to the church so we can put them on our website and stuff like that, make a poster and have everyone see that. This is the last Sunday of the month, and I neglected to put Happy Money in there, but it's a Happy Money Sunday. If you don't know what Happy Money is, Happy Money is, one, it's a little way to raise funds for the pastor's discretionary fund, which helps people who need another tank of gas or who need a little bit of groceries or something like that. An extra meal when they come by the church during the week, whether it is people who are members of the church or not members of the church. It's just a little fund to help out. There's not a lot of money in there, but one of the ways that we fund it is through Happy Money. And how Happy Money works is I walk around, and if you have some news that you'd like to share, some happy news, a brag, or anything like that, you can share that, and then you have the opportunity to put a little money into the Happy Money plate, which goes to the pastor's discretionary fund. I realize you don't have to pay anything to share news. It's just a fun way to raise a little bit of funds for people who need it. So, are we ready for Happy Money? Who's got the plate there? Anybody? Someone bring it around to me. And this is our roving microphone because we still haven't found the handhelds. I thought we had some that were the right frequency, but Ray, we didn't, right? Is that right?
Yeah, I'll start.
All right, Steve.
It is a pleasure to see my son and his friend at church today.
Great to see you. Great to see you. Happy Money?
Happy Money. Happy birthday to Molly on Tuesday, our granddaughter.
Happy birthday to Molly, granddaughter Molly, on Tuesday. Is there going to be cake?
Oh, yes.
Today.
Today.
Happy Monies. John?
Hey, my sister Linda's doing much better. My brother Marty's down there. She's out. She's expected to get out of the hospital, and I think tomorrow.
Awesome. Yeah, thanks, Joe. Great. Other happy moments, Laura?
I'm happy my daughter's coming home from tomorrow, from Ohio.
That's awesome. Others? Thanks, Steve. And no other announcements, right? I do have a little bit of Happy Money news. On next Monday and Tuesday, not this coming Monday and Tuesday, there's something different going on there, but next Monday and Tuesday, my daughter and my son-in-law and my grandson-to-be, or grandson-in-waiting, what do you call it? Expected grandson, granddaughter, I don't even remember what it is. Anyway, baby, grandbaby, are going to be visiting my parents in Florida, which hasn't happened. Like, nobody's visited them except for in emergency times. And so there are some people that are visiting there. And so Trish and I are doing a quick flight down there Monday and Tuesday to get a picture of all the generations together. And so that's going to be exciting. Just a quick little hello down in Florida to my parents and to my grandson and to my daughter and to my son-in-law. And so it's going to be really exciting. So, happy money there. I'll put something in there after. Today's Bible reading is from Jeremiah 32, 1 to 15. You'll see why
I'm not crazy about this passage, but we're going to preach on it anyway. The word of the Lord that came to Jeremiah in the 10th year of King Zedekiah of Judah, which was the 18th year of Nebuchadnezzar. At that time, the army of the king of Babylon was besieging Jerusalem, and the prophet Jeremiah was confined in the court of the guard that was in the palace of the king of Judah, where King Zedekiah of Judah had confined him. Zedekiah had said, "Why do you prophesy and say, 'Thus says the Lord, I am going to give this city into the hand of the king of Babylon, and he shall take it. King Zedekiah of Judah shall not escape out of the lands of the Chaldeans, but shall surely be given unto the hands of the king of Babylon, and shall speak with him face to face and see him eye to eye. And he shall take Zedekiah to Babylon, and there he shall remain until I attend to him, says the Lord. Though you fight against the Chaldeans, you shall not succeed." Jeremiah said, "The word of the Lord came to me. Hanamel, son of your uncle Shalom, is going to come to you and say, 'Buy my field that is in Anathoth, for the right of redemption by purchase is yours.' Then my cousin Hanamel came to me in the court of the guard in accordance to the word of the Lord and said to me, 'Buy my field that is at Anathoth in the land of Benjamin, for the right of possession and redemption is yours. Buy it for yourself.' Then I knew that this was the word of the Lord, and I bought the field at Anathoth from my cousin Hanamel and weighed out the silver to him, 17 shekels of silver. I signed the deed, sealed it, got witnesses, and weighed the silver on scales. Then I took the sealed deed of purchase containing the terms and conditions in the open copy and gave the deed of purchase to Baruch, son of Neriah, son of Maaseiah, in the presence of my cousin Hanamel, in the presence of the witnesses who signed the deed of purchase, and in the presence of all the Judeans who were sitting in the court of the guard. In their presence I charged Baruch, saying, 'Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, take these deeds, both the sealed deed of purchase and this open deed, and put them in an earthenware jar, in order that they may last for a long time. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, houses and fields and vineyards shall again be bought in this land.'" Safe. So today's reading has a whole lot of "times are tough." Blah, blah, blah. Here are some names you will have lots of trouble pronouncing. Blah, blah, blah. Buy some fields. Blah, blah. Make the transactions all legal. Blah, blah. Protect the deeds so that they last. So, according to this particular section of scripture from Jeremiah, property ownership is the big hope. Big hope. The endless pursuit of mine, as it relates to not yours, is caustic. Why is it so important to have something to call your own at the expense of another? Why must something be deemed as exclusive in order for it to be seen as valued and safe? Continue to be frustrated worldwide by how turf disputes poison relationships, bring about war, and lead to hatred. It would be much better if folks could share, gather, welcome, attend to one another, and feel safe in a place that wasn't a "keep off my property" or "don't touch my stuff" turf. You know, a place, a voice at the table for everyone, for all, a place for all. We have to continue to find ways to attend to one another, and at the very least, get along. We've got to get past or get rid of the "this is mine and you can't have that," or "I'm going to take your land and make it mine," or "if I have that, if you have it, then it makes me feel like I don't have it" stuff. Attitudes in the opposite of that ruin relationships, ruin churches, ruin any faith group. "This is mine" type attitudes ruin organizations, communities, nations. It ruins our planet. And the way to end turf wars isn't through more war or more arguing. It is through peace building, through dialogue, through relationships. You know, peace building. I've heard of this before. Let's be advocates for peace building. Get involved with the reviving It's been dormant for a while, but we've been trying to bring it back, the Reviving Peace Mural Project. Making art together is part of peace building. Making art with a message of peace is part of peace building. Sharing that art with the community and letting them share their stories of peace building is peace building. And then there's dialogue. We have to seek to understand why everyone doesn't get it. There are so many opinions about what is the right way to go about working toward peace and change. And it seems that all people ever want to do is argue what is the best way rather than learn from the input of all. Dialogue isn't about getting your message across. It is about seeking to understand messages that aren't yours. And then relationships. Dialogue is one thing. And being in a relationship with people who have vastly different ideas than you do and who have vastly different life experience than you do is another way to be world-changing. Dialogue becomes easier the more you get to know a person and understand them. And while we're working toward peace, let's work together on some goals. How about some world-changing things? Giving everyone access to safe drinking water. Being sure everyone has enough food, shelter, health care, a living wage, equality access, LGBTQIA rights, immigration reform, common sense gun reform, loving our neighbor, loving creation, and seeking to understand each other. I know it's not going to happen overnight. We may have been working on it the entire existence of St. Paul's, and it hasn't happened in the world, but it doesn't mean that we don't keep trying. Peace building, dialogue, relationships. Let's not be deterred. Let's keep working, advocating, living, attending, loving, respecting, reconciling. Let's be a people who continue to work together for good. We can do that. It's a wonderful investment. Amen. I don't know what our song is, but it's not Listening Now. That's the offertory.
Please join me as we do hymn number 72, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
time of offering. The ways that we give, one way is, you know, in the offering plates. We pass the plates and we give. There are other ways to give. You can go to our website and give there. In the bulletin, there's a QR code. You can just take your phone there and click on it, and it takes you to the donate area for St. Paul's United Church of Christ. Some people do bill pays with their bank, and some people mail checks to the church as well. However you give, I encourage you to be generous in giving, because we continue to be in this together. So let's spend some time. This morning's tithes and offerings will now be received.
God is still speaking.
God is still speaking.
So please join in.
To a time of prayer. I have prayer concerns that have been shared in the prayer request cards. Continued prayers for John and Marty's sister Linda as she recovers from emergency surgery and the blood infection.
Thanks for everyone's prayers and well wishes. Prayers for Helen, for Harold, for Elena. Now I'd ask for prayers for me as I go in for surgery tomorrow. I have a spot of squamous cell carcinoma on my face, and hopefully it is not too deep, but they weren't sure during the first process, so I'll be in surgery all day tomorrow and taking a week of sick leave, and hopefully that will knit things up. We don't know. We'll see what happens with that. So let's spend some time now in prayer, first in silent prayer, then we'll say, I'll say a short pastoral prayer, and then we can say our Lord's Prayer together. You can say that in whatever language or custom works best for you. Let's pray. And peace and hope and reconciliation. Thank you for listening. We pray today for strength. We pray today for guidance. We pray today for your peace. We pray as people make difficult decisions about whatever it is, things with St. Paul's United Church of Christ, things with deciding what college to go to, things about deciding who to vote for in an election, things about which bill should be paid and which bill can wait. We pray, oh God, for healing and hope. We pray for prayers that have been shared today in prayer request cards, those that have been shared in comment sections, those that maybe you're just too deep to share, but we know that you hear them. And we lift them all in the name of Jesus, our Savior, who taught us a prayer we could say together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Well, our service is at an end. Do stick around. It's going to take us 4 or 5 minutes. I asked Deborah to play a 1-minute postlude so you can, and then stretch, visit the restroom, whatever it is. But I'm so glad that you are here today for worship, for a special congregational meeting, joining us however you join us. And now, for this part of the service, may the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. May the rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, which may be only a couple minutes from now or later, may God hold you in the palm of his hands. Amen.
See you later, all.